Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us for tonight's 2020 International Baccalaureate Diploma Program Awards Ceremony. Students, I want to begin by congratulating you. Earning the IB Diploma is a very challenging process. The classes you took, including TOK, completing an extended essay, and completing a CAST project are all a testament to your dedication. This is a challenging process, and we are really proud that you've seen this through and been able to complete it. I'd also like to remind you that you should take a few minutes to thank the people that have supported you through this, whether that be your teachers, your parents, your friends. Take a few seconds and say thank you to them. Send them an email, send them a text. Let them know that you really appreciate the work that they've done. So congratulations on a job well done. We look forward to being able to celebrate graduation with you soon and hope that you are all well and safe.
Hi, Ivy seniors. Congratulations on making it through two tough years in the IB Diploma program. I'm so sad that we can't celebrate everyone in person, but I didn't want to end your school year without recognizing each and every one of you and all the hard work you've done throughout junior and senior year. You may not believe this because of all my threatening and passive-aggressive emails, but I really did enjoy getting to work with all of you. It was a pleasure getting to know you, support you when you needed it, and find ways to make you feel special. Your class was unique to me in that you are the largest group of diploma students I've had. I got used to a group of around 70, and then all of a sudden, I had 100 students instead. I worried that I wouldn't learn all of your names and that I wouldn't be able to manage all the due dates and deadlines you had to meet. But aside from the looming CAST deadline in a couple days, we managed to submit everything you needed to on time. And honestly, you guys were better about uploading and meeting deadlines than any class I've had. Your class is also the first group I didn't get to teach in IB English. When I found out this past August that I wouldn't be teaching, I was disappointed because I thought I'd be missing out on really getting to develop relationships with all of you. Though I do miss teaching, I've enjoyed the many ways I've gotten to know you. I've had some great student aides who were not only helpful, but also gave me a welcome distraction when work became too overwhelming. You allowed me to join in on your activities and clubs. Shout out to the Barons in Paradise Club, which I looked forward to every Tuesday. You welcomed me into your classrooms when I wanted to guest teach. And though I hope I was able to teach you something you'll remember, at the very least, I'm glad I could show many of you what a page break is before you go to college. You also volunteered to help me with so many IB initiatives, like contributing to my attempt at a newsletter, creating and participating in presentations to promote IB, and even putting together our first IB showcase. And finally, you all brought your smiling faces to my office at the mention of snacks or hot chocolate. I could go months without seeing some of you, some even ignoring the passes I sent you to come see me. But as soon as there was an email about treats, miraculously, you'd appear in my office. I especially love the hot chocolate week. It sometimes brought out the worst in you, like when no one would refill the water or how my office would be a complete mess as you rushed off to class. But it's also my favorite week because it was a time I got to see you and talk to you outside of the classroom. And even though it made your teachers mad when you were extremely late to class, I selfishly enjoyed those moments when you stayed to hang out and tell me about your lives. You all are extraordinary people. You're not only academic stars, you also excel in sports, arts, service, and more. You may hate CAST, but I personally really enjoy reading about all the interesting things you guys do on top of your rigorous course load. I have no doubt you will all continue to do amazing things, and I hope I will get to see you in person at some point again. I also would like to thank our IB teachers for being so devoted to their classes and the students. It's clear that you've developed a strong bond with many of your teachers who I hope have made your high school experience memorable. Thank you also to our IB parents who help me to support our students and who provide snacks, gift cards, and pretty much anything I need within minutes of me asking. BCC's diploma program would not be as successful as it is without our teachers and IB families. So stay tuned as we will hear from a few other IB teachers and recognize all of you. Congrats again.
Hello everyone, Mr. Savosley here. I know this isn't the way that we envisioned the year ending, but before you all left on the next steps of your journey, I just wanted to take a minute to say a few words. Whether I had you last year as a junior or this year as a senior, I can definitely say that the IB class of 2020 is one of my all-time favorites in my 19 years of teaching at BCC. You guys brought to school and to class every day a positive attitude, an enthusiasm for learning, a willingness to work hard, most of the time, the ability to think critically, a readiness to collaborate and share, and a caring spirit for each other. I was able to see that all of you had the bigger picture of what it meant to be an IB student. So as we end the year I congratulate you on meeting the requirements for IB and for your graduation from BCC. I know you all do great things in your own way as you embark on the next chapter of your life. I can't wait to see what the future holds for each and every one of you. Good luck now.
Congratulations, IB seniors. Miss Corey here. I wanted to tell you what a joy it was to get to teach you in IB English 11. I have so many good memories of our time together, including getting to study and analyze so many different forms of media, from songs to documentaries to TV shows to advertisements, and then getting to read and analyze Their Eyes Were Watching God and Elizabeth Bishop poems. And you are such a thoughtful, intelligent, creative crew, and I hope you really remember all those talents as you leave BCC and go forth into the future. I know you're going to do amazing things, so keep in touch.
Seniors, congratulations, you made it. I guess you're not seniors anymore. Anyway, I'm going to let the movies from your senior year do the motivational, inspirational talking for me. Enjoy.
Do you realize how many events had to occur since the birth of the universe, leading to the making of you?
And when you're down here and you don't think about it too much, but when you get a different vantage point, it changes your perspective.
I just think of myself as that little kid I was. I say, would he have been proud of me? And if the answer is yes, then I know I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be.
Not looking back, only forward.
It's the same story, just a different name.
In every film, there's a moment when the hero hits rock bottom.
Round after round, you learn more about yourself.
You'll do what you have to do, and then you'll do it again.
Find something you really love, and then go after it.
The best things in life happen unexpectedly.
And that's what makes things exciting and fun.
You have to find the truth of it.
We're about to blast off!
Off we go!
We will have a transformative experience.
Let the party commence.
Let's take some time to think of people who have sung you into singing, smiled you into smiling, loved you into loving.
People will remember our movies.
Hey guys, this is take 51, trying to get a video recorded for you guys. It's hard to do without being in front of you. I very much so want to be in front of you guys and be able to congratulate you, wish you the best, feel your energy, and help you along the way as you move forward into the next adventure of your life. You're about to cross a threshold, and that's very exciting. It's very exciting. It's very scary. It's if you're not scared, you're lying to yourself. Don't try in front, because it's scary too. The teachers are trying to put together a few words of wisdom, of which I have none, in order to help you along the way. I'm going to take a second, because we've been trying to get you ready, but no one's ever ready. The people that say they're ready, they're also not telling the truth. I wasn't ready. Your parents probably weren't ready. We went anyway. We took our shot. And more often than not, we land on our feet. So we've been trying to get you ready. Trigger warning, this is a little bit, this could be traumatic for some of you, but I'm going to turn to the board and show you this. Yes, it's our TO Key presentation, and a little bit of the prescribed title. I want to try and make it concrete. The real life situation, that's you guys. You're the real life situation. And the knowledge questions that you should have, they're the questions about why things are the way they are. Who decided that? When will something happen? Why did it happen the way it did? How did it happen the way it did? All things that we just don't have great answers for. And multiple perspectives of key understanding yield differences in understanding. Not everybody thinks the same way. Not everybody has the same opinions. And so we end up with ideas on a spectrum. We do. Our whole country's based on it.
Certainly the political system's based on it, but I dare say marriage is based on it. Having kids is based on it. The world's based on differences in perspective, right? And when you can understand that, when you can understand that real life situations yield these questions that are unanswerable, and the only way we can try and move forward is by respecting varied perspectives, we end up with depth of empathy. And depth of empathy is everything, guys. Certainty? Certainty's a fiction. It is. Complete understanding? It's a fiction, right? And so I'll go back to my notes because I'm running out of time. Clarity, certainty, no one really knows. So what do? We make up ideas, like we make up philosophical perspectives or artistic perspectives like romanticism, realism, modernism, postmodernism, tragedy. If you know the lenses and you know yourself, you can know and go on out the yard. The future, it's not receding before you. That's not accurate. I believe quite strongly that's not accurate. It's what you make of it. Fail? Yeah, you're gonna fail. You're gonna fail big. Everybody does. The wheels fall off the bus. What do? You get back up and you keep moving forward. Know your values, stick to them. For me, it's working hard, sticking together with the people that I love, and caring more about the people around me than I do about myself. Know your values, go out and make your future, guys. I will miss you very much. I look forward to when you come back and visit, and I wish nothing but you the best. Do thank your parents. They've sacrificed a great deal to get you to this spot. Take care, guys, and I hope I see you again.
Hi, IB students. I wish I could be there with you in person to celebrate the end of your 2 years of incredible hard work, but I guess the universe had other plans for us. So I just wanted to send a quick video to say congratulations. You should be so proud of yourselves for all of the things that you've done for the past 2 years to earn the right to call yourself an IB student. It's not easy, and a lot of you did it without too much complaining, I would say. I'm really proud of all of you, especially in this strange, weird time, and your ability to be flexible and willing to try new things, just like your teachers have been trying to do as we learn how to teach online. I wanted to tell you congratulations. I hope that you take this whole story of your graduation and your second semester senior year to heart. I hope that you write a book about it someday. I know that it will just be one of the many things that you're able to overcome, and I know you will achieve great things. I know many of my students already heard me say this, but my final message to all of my students is something that a BCC Baron said many graduations ago, which is, your mom was right. The number one thing you should do right now is to be kind, and that's the number one thing you should do for the rest of your life. As long as you're kind, great things will happen. So congratulations, and hopefully we'll see each other again sometime soon.
Hey, feeling good. When in doubt, I walk around the neighborhood, feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Yeah. Hey, every day can be a better day despite the challenge. All you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna get difficult to stand, but hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way you're round it. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, someday
days you wake up and nothing works, you feel surrounded. Gotta give your feet some gravity to get you grounded. Keep good things inside your ears just like the waves and sound it. And just say whatever, cause there is no way you're grounded. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay, it's okay. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in Durga, walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in Durga, walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best.
I won't give. know the road gets hard and you just wanna leave. I ain't never too far. Just have a little faith in me. When all the fears you have are all you can believe, oh, I'll be standing by your side. Just have a little faith in me. Have a little faith in me.
Show me the way.